Wyoming Rider here, and today we'll be reviewing the Goat Bikes Billy Goat. Very cool bike. Has 20x4-inch Kenda Crusade tires on it, and a 1,000-watt nominal Goat Bikes branded hub motor, and it does have tail lights. Very nice headlight. And it does have turn signals on the front and on the back. If you can see that, has a plastic fenders. It's really nice cross-stitched leather seat. Very nice shocks on, which are air shocks, and you have quite a bit of travel on the front and the back. And I'd have to kind of get on here to demonstrate that. As you see, it's pretty good. Very smooth ride. Yep, and of course the nice double crown, the forks on the front, BMX handlebars. Does not come with this thing. I put that on myself. It's a foam mount that I made myself out of camera mount. Works. Very nice hydraulic brakes, and they are branded Longlin. And very nice color display. Shimano 7-speed shifter. And it has these nice controls here, like for your headlight, turn signals, and a horn, which is pretty loud. And one of my favorite things, move the camera back up here, it has a full throttle. Just very nice. And also the front shocks do have a lockout, an adjustment here, and the air, from what I understand, could be adjusted underneath. And okay, let's move the camera back up here, and we'll do some speed testing so you guys can see how fast this thing is. First, we start out in pedal assist zero here. Get back on the dirt road here. Of course, there's no throttle and no pedal assist power. So let's see how hard it is to pedal. Of course, I'm in a pretty high gear. Gear this thing down to one here. Much easier at one. I mean, it's doable. If I had to pedal at home, the battery died, I think I could do it, no problem. Alright, and if you're bumping on up in the one here. Alright, we're going to do throttle only here. See how fast we can get to you. It's like 10.7 at 156 watts. All right, bump it on up into two. Throttle only. Getting up about 16. We're all going up a slight incline here. So 57. So yeah, we'll see 15.7. Alright, we're going to open to 3. Now we're getting there. 20. 21. I'm going to start to go down a slight hill here. 22. Leveling out. Still at 22. So, yep, we'll safely say that's probably about 22. Turn around here. Thank you. Gone up in the far. Going up the slide hill. Between the four, using an 861 rods. Down to 600 watts. 127, 5, 6, 7. So yeah, 127 there. We'll go down here and turn around and then we'll be fine. We'll get right to the end of the pavement so you got plenty of room. Is 5. Roll on. Already reaching 24. 26. Big one up that hill. Seven, 8, 9, 30. Still climbing, 31. Better use an 1,152 watts. So it looks like, yeah, that was about 31. And that's with me riding, and I weighed about 210. And I'm 5'9. So if you're a little lighter, I bet you could get it to go to the advertised speed 35, probably. And plus, this road's not completely level, so we don't have a lot of those around here. It's pretty hilly. Anyway, pretty dang fast. So now, let me drop it back down in the one, and we'll do pedal assist. Pedal assist, looks like we're going on at C12. Get all the way up in seventh gear here to you. There we go. 14, 15, 16. Not bad. Alright, it's going up in the 2. And I'm still getting a pedal so far. No ghost pedaling yet. 17. Down to 16, going up this little hill here, and we'll level one out. 17. All right, so 17 on that. So let's jump on up into 3. All right, reaching 20. Now I'm starting to ghost pedal. 22. Safely say, yeah, 32. Alright, let's go on up in the 4. The base pedal in the first. I'm gonna run off in the dirt here. Woo! Definitely reaching 45 even on this dirt road here. It looks pretty bumpy. Feels really smooth on this thing. Not too afraid of the gravel on this thing because it handles it better than most of them I've ridden. what we're waiting for out here. About 800 watts. 24. Yeah, I think that's what we're going to reach in 4. So let's go on up into 5. And so you know too, it is accurate now because I did test this with my phone, and that's why we did this part of the video, because it was about 3 miles an hour off of her. Okay, about the same as the fuse and throttle one. Pretty dang fast, if you say so myself. Very happy with this thing. Very, very cool bike, and man, these brakes were excellent. I'll demonstrate that for you now. Let's go get going 20 or so, and then we'll stop. And here we go. Very good brakes. And they do lock up pretty quickly if you get on it hard enough. Just bend out there, take off. So very happy with this bike. It's so freaking awesome. Rides so smooth. Goes fast enough for an old man like me. Can't complain. Oh, there we go, 32. To go here is 32, and I have went 30, almost 36 going down the hills. Is to be expected. And as you see, it handles dirt pretty well. Pretty nice for off-road. Some of these big potholes, and every once in a while you'll hear the something hit. That's the chain slap of the frame. You need to try to tighten that up a little bit. I think it needs like a link taken on of it. But overall, man, excellent, excellent bike. You guys will be very happy with this thing, and I suspect the rest of the products that they have on their site are just as awesome as this one. They definitely seem to have a good quality about them. Good suspension, good brakes, good display, 30 amp controller, and this one did come with a 48 volt 15 amp hour battery, even though it was advertised as a 13. The one that I received is a 15, but that was a good surprise. And they do have 20 amp hour batteries you can get on there too. But yes, this bike on the site is $1,600, but if you use my code down in the description below, it'll give you a 10% discount, which is a quite sizable amount, $1,600. So yes, and I'd appreciate if you would use that. That would also help me out and help me keep bringing you guys new stuff to show off. So yeah, I really appreciate it, and if you have any questions, please let me know. I'll tell you anything you need to know about the bike from my experience so far. Thank you, and I really appreciate you guys if you'd like and subscribe.